Good day, mga kasayik. Welcome ulit sa ating review. Ngayon naman ay magle-lecture tayo tungkol sa ethics in psychological assessment. What makes an action right is the principle that governs it or guides it. Yan yung sinabi ni Remley and early in 2007. But ethics is simply known as moral philosophy, a branch of philosophy that addresses questions about morality, that is, concepts of good and evil, right and wrong, virtue and vice, justice, etc. Since assessment requires practitioner to consider issues of confidentiality and delivery of competent assessment while other decisions may involve informed consent, among others, there is really a need for code of ethics by the various mental health professional organization offering psychological assessment. Ibig sabihin, since tayo ay nagbibigay ng psychological assessment, we have to consider our obligation doon sa ating mga kliyente. But we will be focusing on the PAP Code of Ethics on Assessment. We subscribe to the following ethical standards and procedures related to the following specific functions of psychologists, which includes psychological assessment, therapy, education, and training. And by the way, itong lecture na to ay pwede niyong mabasa sa PAP Code of Ethics, which is available sa website ng Psychological Association of the Philippines. Basis for assessment, the expert opinions that we provide through recommendations, report, and diagnostic or evaluative statements are based on a substantial information and appropriate assessment technique. Imagine, kapag ikaw ay psychometrician na, your opinion may be considered as expert opinion because whatever it is that you opine is based on substantial information and appropriate assessment technique. We provide expert opinions regarding psychological characteristics of a person only after employing adequate assessment procedure and examination to support our conclusions and recommendations. So, sa pagbibigay natin ng opinion regarding the characteristic of a person, dapat natin itong ibase sa sapat na assessment procedure at pagtingin doon sa iba pang mga examination or test to support our conclusion. In instances where we are asked to provide opinion about an individual without conducting an examination on the basis of review of existing test results and report, we discuss the limitation of our opinion and the basis of our conclusions and recommendations. Meaning, may mga pagkakataon na hihingi ng ibang mga psychologists o psychometrician yung opinion natin. Kahit hindi ikaw yung nagpa-test, titignan mo lang yung result ng test o yung evaluation na ginawa ng psychometrician or psychologist, pwede mong makita. Pero, meron ka dapat caveat where you discuss the limitation of your opinion. Because it is very necessary na kapag ka ikaw ang magbibigay ng psychological evaluation, dapat ikaw din yung nagpa-test. Para makita mo din yung observation mo sa kanya about his or her situation while taking the test or the behavior. Kaya nga meron tayong behavior checklist during examination. Now, regarding informed consent in assessment, we always have to get informed consent. We gather informed consent prior to the assessment of our client, except for the following instances. Number one, when it is mandated by the law. Kapag inutusan ka ng judge na gawan mo siya ng assessment, hindi mo na kailangan humingi pa sa kanya ng informed consent. The law says it. Now, next condition is when it is implied. Pagbahagi na siya ng routinary activities like educational, institutional, or other organizational activity. For example, entrance exam sa school. O kaya naman, psychological exam sa mga industry settings. Yan. So, these are part of routinary activity. So, hindi na kailangan ng informed consent. When the purpose of the assessment is to determine the individual's decisional capacity. Kung ang purpose ay para malaman mo kung kaya niya nang mag-decide, hindi mo na kailangan ng letter or informed consent. We educate our client about the nature of our services, financial arrangement, potential risk, and limits of confidentiality. Tandaan natin, bilang mga practitioners, we have to inform our clients kung ano yung mga serbisyo na kaya mong ibigay sa kanya. At sa bawat serbisyo, magkano ang i-charge mo. At kung mayroong potential risk, sasabihin mo din. And of course, you also have to discuss the limits of confidentiality. So usually, ang lahat ng mga bagay nito ay nakasulat sa informed consent. Okay? Like for example, no, or in instances where the clients are not competent to provide informed consent on assessment, like bata pa sila, o kaya psychologically disabled, anong gagawin natin sa informed consent? We discuss these matters with the immediate family members or the guardian or the legal guardian of our client. No? So yung mga minor and those who are not capable of deciding for themselves, then yung legal guardian ang magde-decide para sa kanila. In instances where a third-party interpreter is needed, the confidentiality of test results must be ensured. So, mayroon din pagkakataon na yung standardized test ay halimbawa in English. Yung kliyente mo hindi makaintindi ng English dahil ang gamit niyang wika ay ibang wika. At meron kang kakilala na alam yung wika na yon at gagawin mo siyang interpreter. Pwede naman. Pero, you have to be sure na yung result ng mga bagay na sasabi ng interpreter ay talaga yung tama at it has to be kept confidential. We judiciously select and administer only those tests which are pertinent to the reason for referral and purpose of the assessment. Ano-ano ba yung mga roles natin bilang psychologist and psychometrician? Una, we select the test. Tayo ang mamimili ng test na ibibigay natin sa ating kliyente. Kaya very essential na alam mo ang nature ng mga test na pwede mong ibigay sa particular case. Okay? At bukod doon, pwede rin tayo na mag-evaluate ng test na yon. Or pwede rin tayong gumawa ng test. No? Since psychometrians tayo or psychologist, isa sa mga roles natin ay test development. We use data collection methods and procedures that are consistent with the current scientific and professional development, which also means na dapat nag-a-update tayo ng ating skills. Hindi pwedeng nahuhuli tayo. Tuloy-tuloy ang development ng psychological assessment in the same manner, tuloy-tuloy din na nag-improve yung skills natin para mas ma-develop pa natin yung mga test materials na ginagamit natin. We use tests that are standardized, valid, reliable, and has a normative data directed referably to the population of our clients. So, ang test na gagamitin natin ay dapat standardized test. Pag standardized test, ibig sabihin there is uniformity in administration, scoring, and interpretation. And the test that we will give should be valid, which also means that the test that we are giving measures what it intends to measure. Also, it has to be reliable. It should be consistently measuring the phenomenon that is at stake. And dapat meron siyang normative data. Ibig sabihin, meron siyang standardized score para sa mga target age group participants natin. And next, we administer assessment tools that are appropriate to the language, competency, and other characteristics of our client. Remember, no, karamihan sa mga exam na ginagamit natin ay foreign, so we have to make sure of the readability. Ano yung sabi ng readability? Hindi ito tumutukoy dun sa font, kundi yung kakayahan ng kliyente na maunawaan yung mga termino na ginamit doon sa examination natin. We do not base our interpretation, conclusion, and recommendation on outdated test results. Okay? If we do not base our interpretation on the outdated test result, we also do not provide interpretation, conclusion, and recommendation on the basis of obsolete test. So, ibig sabihin, kapag ka ang test ay obsolete na, hindi na yan dapat ginagamit pa. Interpreting assessment result. In fairness to our client, under no circumstances should we report the test results without taking into consideration the validity, reliability, and appropriateness of the test. We should therefore indicate our reservation regarding the interpretation. Ito na naman. Una, you have to make sure that the test that you are using is valid and reliable. Another thing, you have to make sure that the test that you are using is appropriate with regards to the age or the condition or the purpose of the test. Therefore, if those criteria are not met, you should therefore indicate your reservation regarding the interpretation. We interpret assessment results while considering the purpose of the assessment and other factors such as the client's test-taking abilities, characteristics, situational, personal, and other cultural differences. So we have to make sure na yung assessment ay in consideration of the reason or the purpose of the assessment. Titignan din natin kung yung assessment na ginagamit natin ay hindi ba ito bias culturally? Wala ba itong personal bias pagdating sa gender, socioeconomic status, race, and other things? In terms of releasing of test data, it is our responsibility to ensure that test results are not used by persons other than those explicitly agreed upon by the referral sources prior to the assessment. So doon pa lang sa ating informed consent, ini-indicate na natin sino ang pwedeng makakita ng test na ito. Kung minor yan, bukod sa kanya, yung kanyang legal guardian. Kung yan ay adult, siya lang. Okay? Unless merong talagang written consent na pinapayagan niya, halimbawa yung asawa niya makakita nitong result o yung ibang mga tao ay makakita ng result na yon. Tandaan nyo, hindi tayo ang may-ari ng test and test results. Ang may-ari ng test results na yan ay yung nag-take ng test. Tayo ay custodian lamang ng test na ito. We do not release test data in the form of raw and scaled score. No, hindi mo pwedeng sabihin, Mami, ang score po ng inyong anak ay stay 9-8. Hindi nila alam kung ano yung sabihin ng stay 9-8. So we have to make sure na gamitin natin yung mga terms na may intindihan ng lay person, ng individuals, ng na average individual. So ito ay kailangan natin, lalo na kung gagamitin natin sa korte yung assessment result natin. Okay? So I hope kahit na kaunti ay nakadagdag na naman ng kaalaman ang lecture na ito. Kung bago ka pa lang sa channel na ito, don't forget to subscribe. Ganun din, i-like and share mo na. And don't forget to click the notification bell dahil sigurado ako marami pa tayong susunod na lectures and drills. I hope you are all safe and have a nice day. See you again.